So, the introduction of fuzzy logic, we were discussing. So, fuzzy logic is a method dealing with imprecise data. Okay. And these type of data sets are called fuzzy sets. Okay. So, the concept of fuzzy logic was given by a professor called Lotfi Jeda. He was a professor at University of California. So, Professor Jeda said, you can also use imprecise data for processing. You doesn't need that to have precise data for the processing thing. You can also use unprecise data, like not precise data also. So earlier the processors were not so competent, and so they used to have precise, accurate data for input for processing. But then it was discovered that you can also use imprecise data. Okay. So later on, this fuzzy logic became very popular for control systems. But earlier, this was not given for control system. It was just given as a methodology for computation. So you can understand fuzzy logic with the help of Boolean logic also. So fuzzy logic and Boolean logic have many similarities, but they are also dissimilar. So what happens in a Boolean logic, you can understand. Your Boolean logic will either give you a solution of 1 or 0. So Boolean logic depends on two values, you know, true or false. So our computation also happens like this. And you know that our computers are based on the binary values and binary processing of 1 and 0. But this is not the case with fuzzy logic. Fuzzy logic is based on degrees of truth. Okay. Now you can say what are the degrees of truths. Okay. So fuzzy logic is based on degrees of truths. So degrees of truths means how truth or how false your statement is. That can be said as degree of truth. It is not ha it doesn't happen in usual computation. Usual computation, either we have a true value or we have a false value. Okay. So we can understand it with the help of one example. So if there is a question, for example, is Bob honest? So what will the answer of this question according to the Boolean logic? According to the Boolean logic, either the answer will be yes or one, or the answer will be no or zero. This everyone knows that this happen in Boolean or binary logic. Either the answer will be one, or either the answer will be zero. Okay, true or false. But it doesn't happen with the case of fuzzy logic. So fuzzy logic can have many cases in between also. In between 0 and 1, it can have many cases. It tries to be more practical, okay, in computation. So is Bob honest? If it is extremely honest, then the value will be 1. If very honest, value will be 0.8. If honest at time, value will be 0.4. If extremely dishonest, value will be 0. So you can see there are so many values between 1 and 0. So the fuzzy logic depends on degrees of truth. So there are a lot of application of fuzzy logic, including control system. So you can apply this type of logic either in hardware or software or both. Okay, so we'll discuss this fuzzy logic in detail later on. Now we first go to one more thing, one more method of computation, which is called genetic algorithm. Okay, so genetic algorithm is nothing but it is taken from the method of evolutionary biology. Okay, it is nothing but it is taken from the method of evolutionary biology. So what happens in a evolutionary biology is, you know that in evolutionary biology, genes of two parents combine, and then those genes goes to their children. So the best characteristics of the genes goes to the children. So you have two mating parents, and then you have one offspring or child, and then those best qualities or characteristics or whatever that goes to their children. So we can use this type of methodology. You can say we can take this example from here, and then we design a computational method based on this scheme, and then we see what are the results. So basically what happens here is basically genetic algorithm is applied to very complex problems. It is to find solution of very complex problem. If we have a easy problem, we don't need this. Okay, if we have one solution to a problem, then we don't need it. If we have many possible solutions, so what we do is we say all those possible solutions are known as population. Okay, so as you can see here, all the possible solutions are known as initial population. Okay, and from these initial population, we find two most suitable solutions, and then those two most suitable solution mate with each other and then give us a new more suitable solution. Right, so you can understand it in this way, like Darwin's theory. So what Darwin said, survival of the fittest. Okay, survival of the fittest. So you have to remember this thing. So if you have the solution which are fittest, which are more fit, you will only mate those two solutions. If the solutions are not fit, then the result will also be not fit. So this is how genetic algorithm will work, and we will discuss it in more detail later on in when we will go to unit 4. Okay, then you have some hybrid systems where you can take benefit of both the computation. So you have neurofuzzy, neurogenetic, fuzzy genetic. Okay, so we have discussed three computational method: ANN, genetic algorithm, and fuzzy logic. Okay.